All right, tonight I have a review to make. I'm sorry I'm late with it. I have had, I don't know, I've been drinking, and then I had a, which is great, because I had not been able to drink for many, many, many days and weeks almost, it seems like. Like, almost a prison. If you're not allowed to have the wine in the day, then it is not a normal situation of living. Then it is an under-substance living situation. So I've not been enabled to have a glass of wine for my heart on a daily basis. So I'm already like this is impossible. This is the impossible life that I'm in at the moment, because it has given me such a deficit to my material physical health. I mean, this has been proven again and again and again through science. Every doctor agrees you need to have at least, they say, 3 to 5 glasses of wine a week as a minimum. So I'm like, well, and so where I'm living right now, I've not received this. And so I've not been given quantification factor of even the same as a shelter. So I'm living in quite a predicament of, yeah, I need the money for the wine, for my heart. So anyway, so luckily I had a wine this evening, so I'm kind of happy to have a release moment. But jeez whiz, everyone. So now I have back to work. I have visited. It's a sad deal. Apparently, the Valley Mall there here in Dallas is going belly under, or they're going to delete it. They're going to, I don't know what, turn it into one of those freak shows of the Colorado airport of Denver. Possibly they're going to make it one of those alien landing base station, subterranean. It's possible that's going to be the purpose of it. Yeah, apparently they're going to take it out completely and leave only the movie theater. So it's a strange situation. So I have to respect who is there right now as the major artist of the duration of it for many years, and I imagine so I have my review, and my review today is going to be Legoland. I'm sorry, I'm not sure the full name, it's different. Sometimes I have been referred as it is possible Steven, other times Steve, other times as Stevie. So I'm very confused. I will go with the last one, Steven, because it was given to me from the next door neighbor of the studio. The next door neighbor says Stevie Tate is his name. All right, so that is the name of the gallery. But it's the Kul Ames, but who cares, the Kul Ames, it's going up in smoke quickly. They're going to just completely devastate the entire, what do we call it? Mall. And I don't know what they're turning it into, but they are definitely, I guess my agreement a long time ago to turn it into a big Louvre, a place, has gone away. Maybe it's part of it. Maybe they're going to completely destroy it and rebuild it again. They can do this. You know, they're pretty smart that way. So if they do that, that's great. Also, however, the review is about Legoland. I'll call it Legoland because it's true. Many of the paintings were not really there. They weren't hung on the wall. It was just kind of like heteropiteral. Let's just pack them in there here and just hurry up and just get the heck out. Now, so it had that feeling. Unfortunate, but yeah, it's. When I'm actually looking at the new pieces, there was a new piece. There are two new pieces on the wall that I recognized, and I will call them Lego Land oriented specifica. Now when I mean Lego Land, I mean they're getting a plasticization on the surface. Now these are large paintings. Now, and I believe they're new. What do I know? Maybe they're old ones. But they were large, and also at the and very, very hardened, a very hardened surface. Meaning, it's not like when you're touching, like, oh, you don't touch the Mona Lisa, you know, you scratch her. It's not this situation. We are talking Legos. This is art that is the same as a Lego with a drawing attached on top of it, you know what I mean? But then smothered more in the plastic. So we're dealing with this new art form called Lego Abstractia. So that's where he is right now, this particular Steven Tate. And so in Legolia. So he's there in Legoland. And in a way, it's great, because if you have a painting of this, my gosh, you know, you just need two or three friends to just hate each other one night and just start a brawl fight in your house, and your painting is ruined. But not with this one. Not anymore. Not any longer. You have the freedom. You have the freedom to just be the Jerry Springer hell house anytime you want. It's all about it. It's all about it, isn't it? It's about aggression. These paintings of his now can handle aggression. They can handle aggression full force. Full force. They can handle, gosh dang, you can stick this type of painting out the window in a hurricane and full gale winds and rains. And I believe it would survive and look exactly the same the next day. So in essence, it's almost a feel as you are buying plastic. So I'm not really completely contented with it. I'm not happy with it. I feel it is a little bit cheap, a little bit tawdry. When something is that cheap, I'm kind of disoriented by it. I love it. I love it so much that I can get close to it and I can touch it, and that I will not leave a fingerprint, and that I won't damage it. But in the same token, in the same moments, I feel like, well, gosh dang, me and 100,000 others. So it's nothing special. It doesn't have special quality any longer. Yeah, it has longevity. Has longevity, and I imagine, and it took some kind of a kiln plunge. I imagine it was drizzled in some kind of a wash, a plastic wash, and then shuttled through some kind of a, gosh, some cake and bake factory. It would take a painting that size, and just quiet it on. Because it's not something you brush on, because I know there was no brush strokes evident. There was no brush strokes there, and the parents are like, hey, you got varnish, pal, you got varnish drizzled all over on it, crisscross. No, I'm not seeing any of this. It's definitely looking like it was kiln baked. Yeah, so it has a different quality. Different quality for sure. So this is perhaps a secret to save abstract art. If you live in a kindergarten, if you live in a cafeteria, if you live in a place where people do not respect abstract art, yes, it is answer. But in another sense, it's almost like, excuse me, do we have to sell it to these places? Do I have to sell it to a high school? Do I have to sell it all over there to a medical facility harboring mental institution patients? Do I have to sell it over there for children in a playground so they can throw their volleyballs and their basketballs at it by accident? I mean, is art supposed to be this way? Is this? Yeah. So it's cheap. This becomes cheap painting. So as great as it is in a way, because I really loved it. I loved it. It was hidden in the dark. You can't see it in the dark, so it's kind of spooky. But then on the day breaks, and when the light is there, it's beautiful again. And it's like, oh, wait a minute, look, it's like space, a little like, yeah, I'm out in space. I'm having like my little Neverland out in space time moment for a few, and until the glaze of its event, like, this sucker is plunked, and I mean plunked. It's plunked fat. So it's a space I can't even enter. It's a space I can't touch. You know what I'm saying? It's like an ozone I can't penetrate. And so because it's an ozone I can't penetrate, I can't even go there. It stops me from my fantasial. Do you understand? It stops me from my fantasial space of oh. That was a cosmonaut experience. I've left this planet, gone to another, and maybe 300, 5,000 others more. It's taken it away. You just layered it with plastic. So I'm kind of bummed out. Because it's a beautiful art underneath. It's a beautiful art underneath. The topping. It's like, have you ever had like that ice cream? Like, oh gosh, there used to be this place in the Bay Area called the Fenton's. It may still be there. And they had you could have the ice cream, and it could be like, one flavor, two flavor, three flavors, and then you could have like the caramel, and then on top of that you could have, oh my gosh, you could have the hot fudge, you could have the caramel, or you could have what do you call it? Yeah, maraschinos. But they put at the bottom. They always put at the very bottom. They put like really heavy fudge or the really heavy caramel. And then they would swirl it around all of the ice cream pieces. So it wasn't just like the top and the bottom. It was it went and you know the three in the middle and forgotten. No, it was all swirled down throughout and drizzled, and it was just like a masterpiece of art. Just amazing. So much so that I even forgot what the topic was of this conversation. Yeah, they called it black and tan. Or they had the other one. Yeah, black and tan was my favorite. And then they would have the nuts on it on top of that. But it was amazing. Amazing. But the deal is with it. What? Tangible, tasteable, available. Was that where I was going? Because yeah, that painting was not touchable, tangible, available. As much as I could actually, finally touch it, you know, eventually, you know, I can touch the painting. It was wrong. It was wrong. I would only be touching a farce. Do you understand? I would only be touching a farce. A farce of a space, a farce of an experience, an ozone captured. Yeah, so it was an unfree. It was an unfree. But yeah, I mean the quality is amazing, and it has that yeah, it has that hold of yeah, it's a great painting there. So it's good on the wall. I'll go ahead and give it that. It's good on the wall where you are not close to it. Because I believe when you are close to it, you're saddened by it a little bit. I believe it brings a sad to you. Yeah. Because we like that. We like that. Do not touch. Do not touch. And now it is available to touch. No. No, I think art wants to say, do not touch. Anyway, so that was my critique of his particular what do you call it, new venue deal, new painting style, and what was the other? I don't know. What can I say? Is that, yes, it's tough to critique that particular studio space because it is. I don't know. It's almost over, like I said. So they're in the wrap up. Wrap up. Where are they going? I don't know. I don't know because they are formative. They are formative abstract here in this region, and my gosh, that'll be devastating to lose them. So we have to somehow keep track of where they go. And all of those artists in that mall, we have to find out where they go. And I don't want them to just drift into their little houses and that's it. You know, it's over. Yeah, we have to somehow keep some kind of a story tale, and what we call it, like a directory. We make a directory of who they were and where they went. So like a following. So we follow them. And try to keep track like an alumni situation. Yeah, I think so. I think that would be what do you call it, an organization that would have some kind of allegiance to its I know maybe you didn't want to be with a tribe at all, but that was then in those years, you know. So that's your alumni experience in those years. That's all. So let's leave that with something like that. And he went there or she went there. And maybe we have follow-ups of where you all ended up. And, you know. So, yeah, what else can I say? I believe, like, there was the other, the Lone Star State. I mentioned that was quite beautiful. Gosh dang, I thought to turn it into a poster or something and sell it to big governments. Lone Star State. It's quite a tourist Alamo experience. So yeah, I was thinking that that was it's kind of a major, what do you call it, a major upbringing here for Texans to even see it. I mean, can you imagine how if all the Texans saw it, if the Texans had seen this painting in Lone Star State, they'd be like, oh, proud extra. Proud extra. It's one of those paintings that just makes you proud to be Texas, proud to be Texan. And so in that, I see it. I see it as a, what do you call it? As a an icon, an image, a logo, a manifesto for Texas. And Texas is simply that, you know. Sometimes it is just simply an image. So you sell the image of Texas as the Lone Star State. And what is even funnier, when I went to my little school for girls when I was, you know, I don't know, 8th grade or so, I wrote the Lone Star State. I wrote long story report about the Lone Star State. And funnily enough, I cut it. After I wrote it out for my teacher, I cut it into the shape of Texas, and I had the star there in the middle. So it's very similar, but this painting is a painting, and mine was simply with the paper, Texas, a Lone Star State, you know, and all this, and then all about it, all about, you know, the what do we call it, the informations, the informations of Texas that makes it so great. Inside its portfolio, and so, but it is funny because it's bringing me back to my report that I gave to my history teacher, and I think I only got like maybe a B on it or something, and nothing great, and I was like kind of bummed out because it was like one of my favorite things I've ever done, was to take a report and actually cut it out to be the size of Texas, the shape of Texas. But I think she said inside it was weak. It didn't have enough information. So But I thought the shape was more interesting. I thought the shape was more interesting and deserved an A. But then she did not give me the A. So that's the way it goes. So, but yeah, the Lone Star State, and that was the name of my report. And so there it is. And, but this one, this particular painting of the Lone Star State, is got the pink in it. It's got beautiful colors, and it's love. It has a love of Texas associated, and yeah. So I think it could be very well the tourist idol, the tourist. You know, they say I love New York, I love Texas. Same thing. So it can be that the idolization image given to tourists, they even come as far as, gosh dang, Dubai, or they're coming in from Brasilia. Let's bring them in from Uruguay, or let's bring them in all the way, bring them in from Nome or somewhere, you know. But they need that experience, they need that experience, they need that touch, that tap through. I went to the Lone Star State, you know. I got an airplane, I went to Lone Star State. So it has that power. So congratulations to you for that one. So I will applaud that after the Lego upsettery. That's it. I believe that's it. That's all I have to say about that particular gallery.